We're starting our De Morgan laws. In the De Morgan law is A union B whole complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement, and the second law is A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Now look at the question number 5 of exercise 1.2. And the question number 5 is, verify De Morgan laws if u is equal to n, n means the natural number starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. And A is equal to empty set, means having no member, and the B is equal to prime numbers which are starts from 2, 3, 5, 7, so on. Is it clear? Now you have to solve the De Morgan laws. A union B whole complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement, and A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. According to this, taking the first law, A union B whole complement, which is equal to A complement intersection B complement. Now taking the left hand side, and the left hand side, A union B whole complement means, first of all, you have to solve A union B, write the value of A, which is empty set, union B, which is 2, 3, 5, 7. The answer becomes 2, 3, 5, 7. Now, you have to find the complement. When you have to find the complement of any set, you can write this. A union B whole complement is equal to U minus A union B. Now, put the value of U first, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, minus the answer of A union B, which is 2, 3, 5, 7. The answer becomes those members which are present in U set but not present in this set. This is the basic answer, like 1, 4, 6, so on. Now, taking the right hand side, and the right hand side is A complement intersection B complement. A complement, as I tell you, that complement of any set is equal to U minus the set. Putting the value of U, and the U is 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. And the set A is empty. So answer become all those members which are present in set 1, not in set 2, are 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Now find the complement of two sets. Next set B. B complement, U minus B, putting the value of U, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, minus B, B is 2, 3, 5, 7, so on. The answer becomes members which are present in this set but not in this set. Is it clear? 1, 4, 6, so on. Now, A complement intersection B complement, the answer of A complement. Now putting the answer of B complement, 1, 4, 6, so on. The intersection becomes all those members which are common in both sets are 1, 4, 6. Now look at the answer of A complement intersection B complement, 1, 4, 6, so on. The right hand side, and the answer of your left hand side is 1, 4, 6, so on. Now it's proved. What will be proved? Hence, proved A union B whole complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. Now taking the second law, now our second law is A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Taking left hand side, A intersection B whole complement, which is equal to A intersection B. First of all, you have to find A intersection B. Write the value of A, which is empty set, intersection B. Intersection B means write the values of B. 2, 3, 5, 7, so on. Now the intersection becomes empty set. Now you have to find complement, means U minus A intersection B. The set U is 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, minus empty. All those members which are present in set 1 is 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Clear? Now taking the right hand side. Yes, right hand side is A complement union B complement. First you have to find the A complement, and the A complement is U minus A. Write the value of U. 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, minus A means empty set. The answer becomes 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Now the turn of B complement, and B complement is equal to U minus B, which is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, minus 2, 3, 5, 7, so on. The answer becomes those members which are present in this set but not in this, 1, 4, 6, so on. Now, A complement union B complement. Write the answer of A complement. 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Union B complement. 1, 4, 6, as you know, in the union, we have to combine all the terms, means arrange the terms which are present in set 1 and set 2 also. Is it clear? 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Hence, proved. What will be proved? The second law, De Morgan law, is also been proved. And the second De Morgan law is A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Now the question number 6, which is not in your book but it is for your practice, that you have to know that you have to ability to do the De Morgan law or not. You can do the practice of this question, then you are able to do the De Morgan law. Is it clear? De Morgan law आपने इसमें proof करना है. Values आपके पास given है. इनको देखते हुए आपने De Morgan law जो है उसको proof करके उसकी statement लिखनी है. दोनों laws लिखने हैं और दोनों ही law आपने इस statement के लिए, इस question के लिए जो है वो proof करने हैं. This is not the part of your exercise, but it is for your practice, कि आपकी practice हो जाए, आपको पता चल जाए कि आपको De Morgan law समझ में भी आया है या नहीं. Is it clear? The question is, verify De Morgan laws if U is equal to A, B, C, D, E, A is equal to D, E, and B is equal to A, B, C. The thing which more I want to tell, ki associative law, commutative law, and distributive law, ye bhi aapse paper mein, MCQs mein puche ja sakte hain. Toh jab aapne inki preparation karni hai, toh aapne laws ko bhi prepare karna hai. Is it clear? Thank you, students.